हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न न्यू लेसन दैट इज मल्टीपल्स एंड फैक्टर्स. नाउ लेट्स सी व्हाट इज अ फैक्टर. द नंबर व्हिच एग्जैक्टली डिवाइड अ गिवन नंबर आर कॉल्ड द फैक्टर्स और द डिवाइजर ऑफ दैट नंबर. ओके, नाउ लेट्स सी वन एक्टिविटी. इफ देर आर 12 क्रेयॉन्स एंड टू चिल्ड्रन एंड इफ आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट दैट crayons among two children equally, then each child will get 6 crayon. If there are three children, then each child will get 4 crayon. If there are four children, then each child will get 3 crayons. If there are five children, it is not possible to divide 12 crayon among five children equally. Here, two crayon extra will remain. If there are 6 children, each child will get 2 crayon. If there are 7 children, we cannot divide crayons equally. Here 5 crayon will remain. If there are 8 children, we cannot divide 12 crayons equally. Similarly, if there are 9 children or 10 children or 11 children, we cannot divide 12 crayons equally. Okay, but if there are 12 children, we can divide 12 crayons equally and each child will get 1 crayon. Now from this activity we comes to know that if we divide 12 by 1, the quotient we get is 12 and the remainder is 0. If you divide 12 by 2, you will get quotient 6 and remainder 0. If you divide 12 by 3, you will get quotient 4 and remainder 0. If you divide 12 by 4, you will get quotient 3 and remainder 0. If you divide 12 by 5, then you will get quotient 2 and remainder 2. If you divide 12 by 6, you will get quotient 2 and remainder 0. If you divide 12 by 7, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 5. If you divide 12 by 8, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 4. Similarly, if you divide 12 by 9, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 3. If you divide 12 by 10, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 3. If you divide 12 by 11, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 1. But if you divide 12 by 12, you will get quotient 1 and remainder 0. Here, in this example, when we divide 12 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12, we got the remainder 0. Okay, it means when the remainder is 0, the number is called a factor. Therefore, the factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Here, the smallest factor of 12 is 1 and the biggest factor of 12 is 12. Here, 2 points you should keep in mind. That is, the biggest factor of every number is the number itself. No factor is ever bigger than number. And the smallest factor of every number is 1. Multiples. Let's see the definition. When the division of a dividend leaves no remainder, the dividend is said to be a multiple of the divisor. Now let's take one example. Here in this example, after dividing 27 by 3, we get remainder 0. Okay, it means this 27 is a multiple of 3. Take one more example. Here, if you divide 27 by 9, again you will get remainder 0. It means 27 is a multiple of 9. The number in the 2 times tables are the multiples of 2. Now here 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24 and so on are the multiples of 2. Similarly, the numbers in the 3 time table are the multiples of 3. Here 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 and so on are the multiples of 3. Similarly, the numbers in 4 times table are the multiples of 4. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32 and so on are the multiples of 4. Okay? So, you should keep in mind a number has infinite number of multiples. Now, let's see what is the relationship between factors and multiples. When we multiply 4 by 3, we get product 12. Here, 4 is a factor of 12 and 3 is also a factor of 12. And 12 is a multiple of 4 and 12 is a multiple of 3. Now let's see how to find whether the given number is multiple of 2 or is exactly divisible by 2. For this, there are some divisibility tests. Now let's see test for divisibility by 2. If there is 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in the unit place, the number is a multiple of 2 or is exactly divisible by 2. Now in this example, here on unit place, the number is 2. Here on unit place, the number is 4. Here 6. Here 8 and here 0. It means these all numbers are divisible by 2. Now let's see divisibility test for 5. Any number with 5 or 0 in the unit place is a multiple of 5 or is divisible by 5. Now here in this example, on unit place the number is 5 and 0. So, all these numbers are divisible by 5. Okay? Now, let's see divisibility test for 10. Any number that has 0 in the unit place is a multiple of 10. Take for example 20, 60, 300, 850. Here, in the unit place, the number is 0. So, these numbers are divisible by 10 and also are multiples of 10s. Thank you.